Dear students, as desired by you, today I am going to upload my video on developmental pattern in unicellular eukaryotes. Unicellular eukaryotes are also known as protists, and in protists, protozoans and unicellular microalgae comes. Now, how the development in unicellular eukaryotes takes place? The evolution of developmental pattern in unicellular protists is unique. Every living organism develops. Development can be seen even among the unicellular organism. By studying the development of unicellular protists, we can see the simplest form of cell differentiation and sexual reproduction. In the development of unicellular eukaryotes, nucleus and cytoplasm both play an important role in the unicellular organism. Development is controlled at both the transcriptional and translational level. Sex and reproduction are two distinct and separable processes. Reproduction involves the creation of new individuals, while the sex involves the combination of genes from the two different individuals into new arrangement. Reproduction in the absence of sex is characteristics of organism that reproduces by fission, means splitting of individual into two. There is no sorting of genes when an amoeba is divided or when a hydra buds of cell to form a new colony. In protozoans, reproduction takes place by two modes. First is asexual and another one is the sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, when only one parent is involved, and sexual reproduction when two parents are involved, and reproduction takes place by the fusion of gametes. Asexual reproduction in unicellular eukaryotes are of following type: binary fission, plasmotomy, budding, multiple fission, schizogony and endodiogeny. Now first, the binary fission. In this type of reproduction, one individual divide into two approximately equal part. Mitotic division takes place. Karyokinesis, means division of nucleus, is always followed by cytokinesis, means division of cytoplasm. The fission may be either in a transverse plane or in a longitudinal plane or in an oblique plane or in any plane. This figure shows the various type of binary fission that occurs in protozoans. In amoeba, binary fission takes place in any plane. In euglena, longitudinal binary fission takes place. In paramecium, transverse binary fission takes place. And in ceratium, oblique binary fission takes place. Plasmotomy. It is a special type of binary fission in which the division of multinucleate protozoa into two or more smaller multinucleated daughter individuals takes place, that occurs in mycetozoa. Budding. The budding is the most common method of asexual reproduction of many protozoans. In this method, irregular fission takes place that result in a small daughter individual in the form of a bud. When the bud breaks off, it grows to full size. When a parent body produces only one bud, it is known as monotonic. Example is verticilla. While in multiple budding, several buds are formed simultaneously, and this type of reproduction is known as species is known as polytonic, that occurs in Sectoria. Multiple fission, that is also known as sporulation. In this type, the nucleus undergoes a series of division either by repeated binary fission that occurs in Plasmodium or by simultaneous multiple division that occurs in aggregata. The body becomes multinucleate. After this, the body cytoplasm divide and each nucleus becomes surrounded by a small amount of cytoplasm. These nucleus arrange themselves toward the periphery. This body then disintegrate and releases many offspring is developed into daughter individual. Examples of foraminifera, radiolaria, sporozoa and certain mastigophorans, that is flagellates. Schizogony. In this process, nucleus divide repeatedly, form a large number of daughter nuclei. This is followed by the formation of cytoplasmic bud. The buds are pinched off to grow into new organism. This and formation of meiozoites and sporozoites that occurs in Plasmodium, and formation of gametes from gametocyte that occurs in monocystis. Now the endodiogeny. This consists in the development of two daughter individuals within a single parent, which is destroyed in this process, and that occurs in toxoplasmia. Now we come to the sexual reproduction in unicellular eukaryotes. Sex without reproduction is common among unicellular organisms. Protists are able to reassort gene without reproduction. Paramecium, for example, reproduces by fission, but sex is accomplished by conjugation. Fission is a mode of asexual reproduction, while the conjugation is a mode of sexual reproduction. The union of these two distinct processes, sex and reproduction, into sexual reproduction is seen in other unicellular eukaryotes, for example in Chlamydomonas. In evolving sexual reproduction, two important advances has achieved. First one is the mechanism of meiosis that occurs first time in protozoans. The second was a mechanism whereby the two distinct mating type could recognize one another. This figure shows the type of reproduction takes place in Chlamydomonas. In Chlamydomonas, both the asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction takes place. Asexual reproduction takes place by means of mitotic division, while the asexual reproduction takes place by the process of meiosis. Now, the type of sexual reproduction in unicellular eukaryotes, following type of sexual reproduction are present: syngamy, heterogamy, endomyxis and hemixis. Syngamy is again of following type: hologamy, isogamy, anisogamy and autogamy. Now, what is syngamy? Syngamy is a complete fusion of the two sex cell or gametes resulting in the formation of the zygote, that is known as synkaryon. Hologamy, the two mature protozoans individual do not form gametes but themselves behave as gametes. They fuse together to form zygote that occurs in Sarcodina, Mastigophora and Capromonas. Isogamy, when the gametes are same in size and shape but differ in behavior, they are called isogametes and their union is called isogamy that occurs in Foraminifera and Aphidium. Now, anisogamy, when the two fusing gametes differ morphologically as well as in the behavior, they are called anisogametes. A small and motile gamete is known as microgamete, while the large and non-motile gamete is known as macrogamete. The fusion of gamete is called anisogamete in Plasmodium and Volvox. Autogamy, it is a fusion of gametes derived from the same parent cell that occurs in actinophores. Now, the conjugation. Conjugation means amphimixis that occurs in paramecium. This involves the fusion of two individual and is characteristic of ciliate. In conjugation, the two individual ciliate couple temporarily during division, during mating, with reciprocal cross-fertilization of their gametic nuclei. Several nuclear division takes place during pre and post fertilization event of the conjugation, and the whole phenomena seems to initiate a new life cycle, that is rejuvenance, that occurs in holotrichum. Now, the autogamy, that is described by W.F. Diller in 1936, only one individual is involved, that is self-fertilization of the gametic nuclei that occurs in paramecium or ilia. Cytogamy, R. Wicherman, the two individuals form a pair, but the cross-fertilization of the gametic nuclei does not take place. The male gametic nuclei unite with the female gametic nuclei of the same individual. Now, what is endomyxis? That is described by Woodruff and 114. It is an internal process of nuclear reorganization. It occurs within a single individual and there is no meiosis and fusion of gametic nuclei that occurs in paramecium or ilia. Hemixis, that is described by Diller in 1936, this involves an aberrant behavior of macronucleus in a single individual that occurs in paramecium or ilia and paramecium caudatum. Besides sexual reproduction, following type of reproduction are present in unicellular eukaryotes. First one is a parthenogenesis, regeneration, development of an organism from unfertilized egg that occurs in Chlamydomonas and Actinophores. Regeneration, most protozoan have this tendency. Regeneration is a regain of lost body part. Plasmogamy, in certain rhizopod and mycetozoa, two or more individuals may fuse by their cytoplasm to form a plasmodium in which the nucleus remain distinct and they separate again unchanged afterward. The process, which is thus not sexual and not syngamy, is called plasmogamy and sometimes serve the purpose of digestion of last prey. Now, the conclusion or summary: unicellular eukaryote possesses the basic elements of the development is a more complex organism. Protein synthesis is controlled. Certain proteins are made only at certain time and certain places. Mitosis and meiosis have been perfected. Sexual reproduction exists involving cooperation between individual cells. Such intercellular cooperation become even more important with the evolution of multicellular organism. Thanks.